Welcome to eSignal Learning. This video is designed to illustrate the inner workings and the overall structure of the Advanced Get Type 1 trading model, one of the four core trading strategies of Advanced Get and one of two that is based upon Elliott Wave Theory. The Advanced Get Type 1 trade is rooted in Elliott Wave, but it also combines some other aspects of Advanced Get that are proprietary to help add some validity and confidence to the overall wave counting method. When we're talking about the Type 1 trade, we are focusing on a very specific part of the overall Elliott Wave pattern. To get a brief understanding of how this trade is constructed, we need to have a basic understanding of what Elliott Waves or a typical Elliott 5 wave count actually looks like. To do this, I'm going to use the right-hand portion of my chart as a whiteboard, and we'll walk through the 5 wave count together. Whenever we're talking about a broad 5 wave pattern in terms of Elliott Wave Theory, it typically begins with a wave 1. And because we're looking at an upward 5 wave pattern, our initial move up, our wave 1, or our initial swing, is headed in the upward direction. Once that upward trend has been established, we begin to see a retracement. The retracement comes in the form of a wave 2, a very strong and typically violent correction against the initial move upward. This wave 2 is considered a selling wave. It is a correction, but it is a selling wave, indicating that there are people who are looking to potentially short the market. That being said, after wave 2 has become established, it really holds above the low of the wave 1. This right here, we don't move below that level. In doing so, the bargain discount shoppers step in, and we now get the big, strong, powerful move of this overall pattern, which is wave 3, the most compelling, the most dynamic move of the entire 5-wave sequence. Now, the wave 3 is typically the strongest move because it is comprised of two different groups of traders. The first one is, remember, wave 2 is a selling wave. We had a group of short sellers stepping in here looking to drive the price down. However, because we were not able to move the price action below the prior low of wave 1, all of a sudden those short sellers are realizing that the price is no longer falling. They begin to cover the position, and once we move above the high of wave 1, we now have two groups. We have the short sellers who are looking to cover and protect their position, and we also have momentum traders who are stepping in and helping drive the price higher. So wave 3 is typically the strongest move of this overall pattern, the strongest part of the trend. It's where most momentum traders like to do business. Now, after the overall wave 3 has been established, some profit taking begins to occur. That profit taking comes in the form of wave 4, another corrective wave. Now, just like wave 2, wave 4 is a correction. However, it is not a selling wave. It is a profit-taking wave. Wave 3 was very, very powerful, very strong. And with that profit in the bank, people begin to take some money out of the market, protect the profits, and that profit-taking process causes our wave 4, the next correction. The final wave of this overall pattern is wave 5, a move to higher highs. This right here is typically what we are trying to capture using the Type 1 trading model. One of the key aspects of Elliott Wave Theory is the understanding that markets like to terminate on their second attempt at a new high or a new low 68 to 74% of the time. As we are making the Wave 5 high, it is typically happening with less enthusiasm, less energy, and in essence, a weaker move. While it is making a new high or low, it's happening with less enthusiasm. Our whole focus using the Type 1 trade is to identify the end of wave 4 so we can capitalize on the final move of the pattern, wave 5. This right here is what the Type 1 trade is designed to capture because it's the most predictable. Well, why is it the most predictable? In essence, you have to think about it in terms of psychology. If wave 1 is true and wave 2 is doing what we expect it to do, if wave 3 is holding up its end of the bargain and maintaining all of the relationships that go into Elliott wave counting, and wave 4 is doing what we expect, We have no other option but to assume that Wave 5 is going to follow suit. That right there is what makes the Advanced GATT Type 1 trade the most accurate trade out of the four core trading models. We are looking to capture the last and final move, but the easiest move to see coming. With that five-wave pattern clearly in our mind, and with a sense of understanding of how this pattern unfolds, we can now take this pattern and apply it to other chart patterns, whether it be currencies, futures, stocks, and even options. We can apply this pattern to help identify how to capture the final move of this pattern, wave five. With that understanding of the five-wave sequence using Elliott Wave analysis, let's put it in real-world terms by taking a look at the daily chart of IAC Interactive Corp. In this particular chart, we have that same five-wave pattern occurring. To help illustrate it, I'll use my arrow, and we'll walk through that same five-wave pattern that we talked about in the broad sense using the right-hand portion of our chart. In this case, you can see that we've built here our wave one. We now have that strong, violent pullback of wave two, typically very strong. And from here, the all-important wave three. And from here, again, a profit-taking wave of wave four. At this point, all of the makings of a good type one trade are in place. In addition to the fact that the pattern has become established, you'll also want to take note that we do have a way to help identify these waves clearly and easily. One of the powerful aspects of Advanced GATT is that it does all of the wave counting for you. It does essentially the heavy lifting to help identify what piece of the market you are currently working with. With that five-wave pattern now beginning to sort of come together, you'll notice that there's some other elements to this particular chart. The one that's probably the most important is down here at the very bottom. This is the Advanced GATT Oscillator. This oscillator is designed to help identify when we are in fact looking for the wave four to be completed. The Advanced GATT Oscillator is there to help tell us when we should expect a Type 1 trade to begin coming together. The Advanced GATT Oscillator makes up a critical component to the Advanced GATT Type 1 trading model. When the Type 1 trade was being conceived, we were looking for things that happened on a consistent basis during wave 4 to help identify when wave 4 was actually completed. What we found in terms of that came in the form of the oscillator. This oscillator right here tells us when wave 4 is likely to be done, because if we take all the market data back to 1960, approximately 94% of the time during a good wave 4 correction, the oscillator pulls back to zero. Now we do allow for some wiggle room. There are some very specific thresholds that we adhere to make sure that profit taking, or the wave four, is happening with a fair amount of reason. In addition to the Elliott wave count and the Advanced GATT Oscillator, you may also notice some other components on the chart. The first one is what we have here called the PTI, which stands for Profit Taking Index. The Profit Taking Index is directly measuring the way profits are coming out during wave four. Wave three was a strong and compelling move. There was a lot of money to be made here. However, we want to make sure that that profit taking during four happens in an orderly fashion. We don't want to see a complete capitulation or reversal of trend. In addition to the PTI, you may also notice these channels. These are the wave four channels, and they are essentially lines of probability to give us a hint of how likely it is that we will print a higher or lower wave five, all depending upon direction. With that in mind, what we're going to do now is use another tool of Advanced GATT to help us identify where we should be doing our profit taking in the course of this type one trade. To help us with that, we're going to use the MOB, which stands for make or break. The MOB comes in right around $54.50. This is the area within the Type 1 trade where we should be taking profits and exiting the trade. From here, as the trade unfolds, you can see how the price action has now run into that area, and in turn, we have now printed our new Wave 5 high, thus completing the overall Elliott 5 wave pattern. As previously mentioned, not only can Type 1 trades be found in uptrending markets, they can also be isolated in downtrending markets. In this example, we're looking at the S&P 500 Holders Index, the SPIDERS, the S&P 500 tracking stock. In this example, we're looking at a daily interval, and you can see how Advanced Get has isolated the Type 1 selling opportunity that occurred during the Great Recession. That same five-wave pattern is stated again. We have our wave 1, wave 2, our initial correction, the big, strong, powerful move of wave 3, a profit-taking phase, wave 4. From here, during wave 4, our oscillator, most importantly, has pulled back to that zero area, helping identify that wave 4 is likely to be completed. Our PTI is within its acceptable parameters, and the wave 4 channels are telling us of a high likelihood of a lower wave 5. In addition to that, we can reincorporate the MOB and help identify a level of support just beneath $70. From here, the price action continues to unfold, and we now have our completed five-wave pattern. Not only can these trades be found during uptrends and downtrends, but they can also be found on daily intervals, intraday charts, and not only isolated to specific stocks, but the broader market as well. One of the things that's important to understand about Advanced Get is the fact that the tools and the strategies are incredibly powerful, but it's also not the complete picture. Another part of the Advanced Get package includes education from eSignal Learning. When you begin to put the tools and the education together, you now have the complete formula of not only using the best tools on the market, but having the skills, knowledge, and education to use those tools to their fullest potential. It's very much like having a driver's license. You may have access to a car, but if you don't have a driver's license, you're not going to know what to do in incredibly critical situations. The education of eSignal Learning, coupled with the tools and trading strategies of Advanced Get, provides that complete picture. eSignal Learning includes real-time online trading and education with experienced traders. We do that via mentoring sessions and a library of foundation videos. We also have the Advanced Get Trading blog, where our instructors illustrate points of interest across various asset classes. In addition to that, we also have monthly member events and a library of videos on different trading-related topics as it all relates to Advanced Get, and even live advanced trading seminars where advanced topics and skills are gained.